way to Kent and then to Scranton, even to the top of the Manhattan Bridge. You will make a new sensation, have a growing congregation, build a flowing operation here below. Like a pie, pepper glowing, baby, keep the music flowing, keep the rhythm going, go, go, go. You will make a new sensation, have a sensation, build a flowing operation here below. Like a pie, pepper glowing, baby, keep the music flowing, keep the rhythm going, go, go, go.
Is the diversity of America. And tonight we'll hear music from Broadway to folk, from Afro-American work songs to jazz, and other Americana songs. That's all American music. So tonight we're going to take you on a little journey of American songs. The first song we opened is one that was written by Francis Scott Key, the national anthem, by the commencement singers who will be honored by singing the national anthem at the 2016 commencement here at Folsom Lake College. And that's about as American as you can get if you sing the national anthem. And the thing about find interesting about that song is that everybody knows it, but nobody wants to sing it. Great piece to belong to. The second piece we did was Sarita, which is a Zimbabwe greeting. Now you'd say, well, how does a Zimbabwe greeting end up in all-American music? And I'll tell you why. Because it was written by Resephany Powell, a former colleague of mine at Florida State University, who's fast becoming one of the preeminent female Afro-American composers in America. And this is a song she heard as a child, and she wrote it into a choral piece. And then we sang our favorite and yours, The Rhythm of Life. So we're going to change things up a little bit, And we're going to go to a solo. We said jazz, and definitely we're going to have that this evening. And so Dean Kay and Kelly Gordon wrote this little piece in the 60s. And it was a cover for an English jazz singer called That's Life. And she sang it, flopped. And then some guy who was nicknamed Blue Eyes picked it up. And it was an amazing hit. Well, tonight you're going to hear One Step Above Blue Eyes. And we're going to have Connor come out and sing That's Life. that was kind of a teaser for Randall Thompson, which leads into our next section, which is seven country songs, which we'll hear four tonight from Frostiana, the song cycle, written by Randall Thompson. Now, Randall Thompson was a very sought-after composer in the 30s and 40s and 50s and 60s, and it was the town of Amherst, Massachusetts, that decided they would celebrate their bicentennial, 200 years, by creating some special work that represented the people and the activities of the town. So they picked Randall Thompson, and they asked one of their part-time residents, some guy named Robert Frost, to set seven, for Thompson to set seven of his songs. We're gonna hear four of them this evening of the seven song set. We're gonna hear a mixed chorus, we'll hear a women's chorus, a men's chorus, and then a mixed chorus. These pieces have really been timeless, and they really describe the activities of people that live in the country, in particularly Amherst, Massachusetts, and the country life, and kind of describe that. Of course, only the way Frost can write, and then Thompson can set those poems to music. I asked during the four sections or the four movements that you not applaud between sections. We'll sing for you seven country songs by Randall Thompson.
Oh, Oh, well, they all go to their spot.
Aren't those great pieces?
I've heard a lot, and it's just wonderful. So
this ensemble is a non-auditioned ensemble. That means it's called, in the South we call it the Y'all Come Choir. And the Y'all Come Choir is an ensemble that anyone can join, whether you've been told you're a singer, or whether you've been told you're not a singer, or whether you've been told to sing elsewhere. Or as my mother used to say, sing solo, so low we can't hear you. Now, that's what it comprises of these folks. They're all from a wide variety of disciplines in the college. And some will return to learn, and some are going on to their careers in transfer education. But it's interesting, let's take a little poll. How many of you, this is the first time singing in an ensemble, choir? Not bad, huh? And if they can do it, you can do it. So you didn't know, but secretly, we've been auditioning all of you this evening. And we look forward to seeing you. The ensemble meets on Mondays and Wednesdays from noon until 2. Or you can meet on Tuesday night from 6 to 9. And then for 3 rehearsals, we glue 2 ensembles together. Hard to believe these are 2 ensembles. Not bad, huh? You could be the next star. You could be up here. Tell your neighbors, tell your friends. Here's a great opportunity for those of you who've always been told, you ain't a singer. That guy, Dr. Noonan, said, I'm a singer. You are. It's in your body, believe it or not. And these folks are experiencing it for the first time. So, good luck. Good. A lot of them are coming back, too. So, we move on. Now a little bit of Americana. How many have heard the song, Home on the Range? You may sing along. And so tonight we do a little bit different in terms of the arrangement. This is a Mark Hayes arrangement that features our harmonica player, Robbie Hastings. Thank you. Norman Luboff and the Norman Luboff Singers for many years had quite an audience. What Norman Luboff did well was to travel the country and sample sounds of indigenous music or folk music and rewrite it for choral ensembles. This is part of a Bahamian tune of all my trials, and basically is a mother holding her children as she dies. Oh. That's coming next. See? I kept you on task. That's not. At least the conductor doesn't know where you're going. Okay, my other story. James Irv was director of choral music at the University of Richmond for about 35 years. And in 1971, he took his group, as I did in 1990, to a European concert tour. Now, when Europeans, they love Mozart and Schubert and Schumann and stuff, but what they really love is American music. And so he wrote an arrangement of O Shenandoah, reflecting the area of Richmond and the Shenandoah Valley, and really wrote this piece, which has been a little bit timeless, and yes, it's time to move. And it's still today very popular with choral ensembles, especially festivals, and for touring ensembles. And our first European tour we'll sing, which you'll all sing with us. This is James Irv's arrangement of Shenandoah.
Oh, Shenandoah, I long to see you, my dear, your lingering eyes.
These folks, in 16 weeks, have put this concert together. They learned it. And speaking of that, let me introduce our wonderful accompanist and my assistant, Shelley Brink. It is amazing. And last semester, last fall, we did four other large choruses, and we did Benjamin Britten's Ceremony of Carol with concert harp. So these folks have done a lot of repertoire this year. So congratulations to you. And more to come. Our fall concert, which you will all be singing in, is called Great Choruses, the Sacred, the Secular, .. and the Profane. And now we sing All My Fun. Moses Hogan, I had the chance in 1999 to listen to Moses Hogan at the ACDA convention, the American Choral Directors Association convention, premiered his ensemble, the Moses Hogan Singers, from the First Baptist Church in New Orleans. And Moses Hogan's mission, and that mission of the church, was to preserve Afro-American work songs. And he arranged those for choral groups and did very well and really set, there's something when you're around 5,000 conductors that give you a standing ovation. Something's to be said about the work and the singers. Well, tonight we sing one of his pieces, an arrangement of Elijah. You know what happens to Elijah? Caught up in the whirlwind and up to heaven. Way you go. Unfortunately, Moses Hogan died in 2002 at the height of his career at the age of 37 years of age. And so his legacy lives on. And so we sing Elijah.
Call. I hope.